With sporty looks, coupe styling, 4x4 capabilities, this Range Rover Velar D300 in the beautiful Firenze red with 11,000 miles on, one owner from new and full Land Rover service history. Another good part of this car is it's got the remainder of the service plan, which is the next two services, fully paid for. You've then got things like the black styling pack and around £6,000 of extras. Today with the life price in this car's 42,990. The D300 is a 300 brake horsepower and this was the R-Dynamic SE as well, so it is fully loaded. The black styling pack is a black badges, the black grille, so it's fully de-chromed in every single way. You've then got the LED headlights with the LED daytime running lights. All the inserts in the bumper, where normally they'll have rose gold tints on them. Even the front splitter is also done in high gloss black. As you come round to the side of the vehicle, you'll see the start of the accent, which then continues down the side of the car, and the rear bumper as well, also done in that high gloss black, that continuous black black styling pack even. Side air vents and the top vents as well, also done in black. You've then got the upgraded 20-inch alloy wheels on this, which again in perfect condition, there's no corrosion, no curb damage, nothing like that. And as you can see, it fills the arches ever so well. Another thing on the D300 R-Dynamic SE is you have got the adjustable suspension as well. So this is sat on access height, so it's quite low, so it's easy to get in and out of, but it does lift up and you can adapt that as and when, depending on your driving terrain. You've then got the R-Dynamic badges, the black mirror caps, the sun protection glass, the lovely black window surrounds, and you've got the full panoramic glass roof, which is quite an expensive extra. If you look at the door handles, they're very flush. The mirrors are folded in, but with the flush door handles, again, just looks very slick. If I press this button, that's what we call hands-free access. So as long as the keys are in your pocket or in your bag, you press the button, it unlocks, pops out, hand goes in, open it up, dead easy. You then got this beautiful two-tone leather in this one. They come in different variations. I've had red ones with black and different sort of variations in general. This one's got the black and white Alcantara for the black section, so it's nice and warm and soft, and then the full perforated leather, and that's front passengers, front seats and the rear seat as well. Another extra on this one is the ambient lighting, which is the door cards, the centre dash, footwells and everywhere else. The top dash is leather, again split in two, ivory and black. The Meridian sound system, which is the extra speakers all around the vehicle, but it's just good quality, because remember, this car's done 11,000 miles, and that's what makes it special. The Firenze red is a metallic red, the combination of the interior, it's just, if I was to build one, this is something very similar to how I would build one, if that makes sense. Condition, genuinely, the back seats don't look like they've been sat in. You've got Isofix attachments, 3-point seat belts, the pockets for the rear magazines, any sort of tablets and whatnot, fully fitted mats, and then if you come back around, you'll see the ambient lighting reflecting just under the door card in the pocket down here as well. The rear seats also recline ever so slightly with this button here, so if you want a more upright position as a rear passenger, you can just press this here and it does it, tilt it forward, so you're sat at a more of an upright angle, because if you have got a bad back, you don't be stretching back really. But how nice, it just feels really good. So even though it's got coupe lines and it's got a sporty look to it, there's still lots of headroom, leg room and everything else. Continuous of that LED style rear lighting system, LED rear indicators, and then you've got the black styling on the back as well with the badging and the trimmings. All the badging down here are also done in black. Automatic tailgate, you've got the twin tailpipes, one on each side, and another very big extra which cost pretty penny is this one's got the electric tow bar, so the switch is in here. If I press this, it takes about 15-20 seconds. It's out of sight, out of mind, so it doesn't look hideous. But when you press that button, a tow bar pops out. How cool is that? And it's very useful as well. So if you are going to tow with it, it's awesome. It's a D300, so it's the best you can get anyway, as far as Velar goes. Press it again and it falls away. Here you've got the previous customer left in the boot liner. Underneath, it's brand new, massive boot, and you've also got a spare wheel. It is only a dinky one, but it's better than nothing. Press the button, it locks up. So the other thing with a deployable tow bar is sometimes, if you're doing it aftermarket, they'll cut a section out, so you can see the lip on this one. So this is purposely designed for that electronic deployable tow bar. So again, it looks great. Zero damage on the car, zero damage on the wheels. There's no dents or scratches anywhere to be seen. Just a very nice example. You've then got things like hazard warning assist, so as you're switching lanes, that'll flash away. You've got the memory seats here, 1, 2, 3, electric mirrors, electric windows, and push button start. But this is where it comes to life. I think the outside of the car is brilliant. It looks super sporty. It just looks very modern because of the curves and the lines and the wheels and everything else. But then if you're driving and you're touching this steering wheel, it feels so up to date. I love the little silver trimming inside the steering wheel. You've got the same contrasting split colors. You've got the black and the white as well, which is also leather wrapped. All the ceramic finishing to the dials, which also light up. So you've got lane assist there, cruise control, Bluetooth controls and volume and everything else here. Massive extra, and I haven't seen many Velars with this. This one's got heads-up display.
It doesn't work because of the nature of the model.
That's a radio. The heads-up display is amazing. Speed, how fast you go on the road, how fast it should be going, what gear you're in, navigation, Bluetooth details, almost everything they're going to use day to day without having to look to the left or look down. You can just look at the screen because the heads-up display, it reflects it all into the windscreen for you. So again, a cracking option. The tilting full touchscreen media screen. How easy is that? I'll just turn this down a little bit so you can hear me. So you've got navigation, media, phone, and then as I go across, you'll see Apple CarPlay. I'm talking about this more and more these days because everyone asks about Apple CarPlay, and this one's got it, which is massive. The wider screen lens, the deployable tow bar, ambient lighting with the different colours. So if you're not into purple, you want red, you want blue, you choose, and how bright you want it to go as well. Camera system, you've got the reversing camera just there, the automatic gearbox, dual zone climate control, and here's the suspension button. So at the minute I'm on the low setting, I can go on the mid height, what you call comfort ride, normal height, or you can go for the higher height, the highest one, the off-road height is what they call it. This is all touchscreen as well, heated seats and climate control all there, just at your fingertips, very easy to use. The panoramic glass roof, if you're looking, it's massive, it is huge. And sometimes people think, well, why do I need that for? But it lets so much light in, so again, it feels very airy. And if you have kids, that's all they do is look up, and it's a nice little touch. But if you don't want that, because you don't want any light to come in, you want it dark and sporty, you press this button, and the electric blind that'll cover the full glass roof. Twin cup holders, your centre armrest splits in half. There's more USBs in there and a cubby hole in there. Just a brilliant place to be in. Just to recap quickly, 11,000 miles, one owner from new, full Land Rover service history, and some of that will save you a few pounds is the next two services is paid for. Ferenz Red, D300, R-Dynamic SE, with lots of extras, 42,990, an amazing car. My name is Joe, my name and number's on the bottom of the screen. Give me a call, drop me a text or WhatsApp me, I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching, bye-bye.